How did it evolve from the album to the book?
Well, I got a call from Frances Foster saying, I really think this would make a magical children's book, and would you consider Barbara McClintock as an illustrator?
Both the music and the poetry evoked so many images to me that I realized that the only way I was going to exercise them out of my brain was to actually draw them and put them into a book. I mean, your music has brought these poems back to life.
So you were self-taught as an artist, and you were self-taught as a musician. How did you develop as a musician? How did that happen?
Well, I took piano lessons from the time I was 8 till I was 8 3/4, until I had to play my first recital, which horrified me so deeply that I refused to go to piano lessons again. And a little voice training in public school from a very generous and loving choral instructor. But otherwise, I joined a band when I was 16, and I started writing songs. And I was too busy being a musician to study music.
I can credit the public library system with my art school education, as I taught myself to draw. I just copied every drawing in the book and then returned it and picked out another book. I remember an artist coming into my kindergarten class and drawing for us, and it was just like an epiphany for me. It was like, gosh, I could grow up and be like this person.
So now if we go over to this table, I can show you some of my pen and my ink and some of the things I used to make that picture.
So I use pencil and paper. This is watercolor paper. In fact, if you want to pass this piece around, how bumpy the watercolor paper is.
Look at all these bumps. First,
I do a little sketch. Just dip my pen in here, and then I start to draw.
Is this wind?
You know, it could be wind. Let's make it wind. I like that very much. Should there be a moon?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like children are so sensitive and so intelligent, and there's so much entertainment that's being produced for them that I feel doesn't honor that.
If you look closely, all these men are blind, and they're walking up to the elephant, and since they can't see, and they can't, so they don't know what the whole elephant looks like, they can only tell, like, if this is all I felt, I would think little boys were very hairy everywhere. This blind man walks up and he feels just the leg, so he thinks it's, what would you think if you felt something like a...
Like hard.
Like hard. So he thinks elephants they're a lot like trees.
I really wanted to make a piece of art for children that would respect them.
My favorite song is The Land of Nod.
I like the adventures of Isabel because I like fast tempo.
My favorite poem is If No One Ever Marries Me.
I like that song because bugs can't really play music, so just for like once, there's a little imagination in there.
She's very brave and strong and feeling. She has a lot of imagination, and I like her.
Sometimes when I sleep, I have dreams. Like, I have a sheep, I have a pet squirrel, I have pet bunnies, I have a pony.
The Land of Nod is different. It's like, you walk into this beautiful place and then you don't have to think about nightmares anymore.
She turns her into milk and drinks her, which is really funny. And I have no idea how she can do it when she's just a regular girl that has very strong feeling and very good character.
It's not passive entertainment. I think it's very active.
Yes.
And then we're planting little seeds. We're planting these little seeds of poetry in their heads that that will stay with them for their entire lives.
Ari was telling me that this is his painting of the land of Nod. These are the stars in the sky. This is the dark night, the dark land. And what are these shapes here?
Those are things that are magic in the poem that I thought was in the land of Nod.
Those are the magic things happening. I love these,
you
are these mountains.
You fought it yours way.
Is this grass?
I fought it my way. I thought the Sleepy Giant was like wearing these ripped clothes.
Yeah, that's how you imagine?
Yeah.
Mine is calico pie when the birds are flying to the tree.
And they're going to the water, and then they're going to go to the tree where their house is.
Okay. The beauty of this is that it really offers children of all stripes, you know, some access to these really wonderful poems.
Children are going to be inspired to write poetry from this book and to illustrate them.
And to write music. Every child has their own individual way of comprehending and understanding the written word. It was always the visual thing first for me. That visual link kind of led me into the text.
I think for teachers, there's so many different disciplines that are addressed. It's so multisensory. They can sing, they can dance around the room, they can imitate your drawings, or they can close their eyes and imagine drawings of their own. You see how transformed these children are. I've been a musician now for 30 years. Maybe some people can do this into their 70s, but the graceful progression of my life that I see, my role as a musician, is to become involved in arts and education. I think it's crucial work to be done. I'm just so grateful that they have engaged, devoted teachers. And so I'd like to be part of that mission.